For the first episode of the Here and How podcast that me, Thomas Westbrook and Rachel Oates are hosting, we decided to investigate the history of science, and during our research we found many fascinating facts. For example, did you know that the peer review process has only been around since 1665, or that the first controlled placebo trial didn't occur until as late as 1937? Pretty surprising, right? Anyhow, while researching for the show, I stumbled upon a man that I had somehow never heard of, but who is nevertheless credited as the father of philosophy, the father of science, and, after becoming acquainted, I would argue is also the father of irreligion. His name was Thales of Miletus. Now, I entirely appreciate that there's a chance that you already know of this man, and that further still, you might know precisely why he matters. But since most people don't, this is the most important person you've never heard of. On the 28th of May, 585 BC, a long-waged war between the Medes and Lydians came to an abrupt end, when while clashing swords, an eerie darkness, which was caused by a solar eclipse, enveloped both armies. They, of course, interpreted the event as an omen from the gods, but Thales didn't, because he had, well in advance, accurately predicted it, and in doing so, he had become the first. This alone, which has been subsequently supported by modern astronomy, demonstrates Thales' genius, but what makes this prediction so damn important is that he achieved it by doing what no other had done before. That is, he refused to assume that nature is controlled by the gods, that thunder comes from Zeus, earthquakes from Poseidon, and famine from Limos. Instead, he hypothesized that nature follows inherent laws that can be understood, and he had just proved it. To quote the documentary, What the Ancients Knew, Thales dared the gods and thereby demystified the world. He cast aside tradition by asking the critical question why in the effort to find underlying laws. This became the foundation of science. What's more, and to quote the sorely missed legend that is Carl Sagan, this was the first conflict of which we know between science and mysticism, between nature and the gods. A conflict which, as we unfortunately know all too well, still exists today, and in my opinion will do so forever, if only because we'll always bear the lowly stamp of our origin, and with it the deep desire to be the center of the universe.
This crazy evolution theory that they're teaching in the schools is dumb. It didn't happen. You didn't come from a monkey or an ape-like ancestor. And dinosaurs did not live millions of years ago. Dinosaurs lived with Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden.
Anyhow, Thales used his new scientific approach, though it wasn't called that at the time, to make many hypotheses about nature, such as that all land floats on water and that earthquakes are the result of turbulent waves crashing into the land. Of course, these hypotheses, like many of his, turned out to be incorrect. But to once again quote Sagan, whether Thales' conclusions were right or wrong was not nearly as important as his approach. His hypotheses were, unlike those made by his religious counterparts, falsifiable, and as such could be disproven. In a nutshell, this is why Thales matters, and it's why I'm annoyed that I wasn't taught about him at school, and that those who were seem only to know that he mistakenly thought that everything is made of water, which is a criminal account of the man, and, to be honest, one of the biggest reasons I've decided to create this video. Thales was a brilliant person, and if you're not already convinced of this, then the following anecdote should change your mind. According to the likes of Aristotle, Thales, in response to being mocked by his contemporaries for being poor, which was a fact that they used to dismiss his intelligence, used his scientific approach to predict a particularly great harvest, and then, in advance and at a discount, reserved all of the olive presses in Miletus so that he could rent them out at a premium during the peak of the season. And thus, he made himself rich. Now this act, in my opinion, was not only one of Thales' most important, but is one of humanity's most important, because in doing this he demonstrated that the accumulation of wealth and science go hand in hand, that knowledge really is power, that if you know what your competition does not, then you're at a tremendous advantage. Now I could go on for hours about the feats that Thales evidently achieved, such as his discovering of the timings of solstices, equinoxes, and seasons, and his many mathematical theorems. But in the interest of time, I'll leave you with just one more. According to Cicero, Aetius, and many other scholars, it is very likely that Thales figured out that the Earth is a sphere. The reasons for this, in short, is because, as a well-travelled man with an avid passion for astronomy and geometry, he would have observed that during a lunar eclipse, the shadow caused by the interposition of the Earth between the Sun and the Moon is always convex, that some stars which are visible in the south are never visible in the north, and vice versa, and that while, at sea level, distant objects appear to sink into the horizon, they can be brought back into sight by viewing them from a higher vantage point. However, with this said, it would be remiss of me not to emphasise that likewise to most of what we know about antiquity, we can't be certain on what exactly Thales thought, nor if the discoveries and stories attributed to him actually happened. But what we are certain of is that Thales' revolutionary scientific approach, which necessitates the refusal to assume the involvement of the supernatural, did indeed occur, and that this paradigm shift is one of, if not the, most important in our story. Among philosophers and scientists, Thales is acknowledged as their father, but I would argue that because of his refusal to assume agency until proven, he is also the father of irreligion, be that whatever name we go by. The first time I read about Thales, I instantly fell in love, and my hope is that you do too. Thales is the most important person that you hadn't heard of. Anyhow, as always, thank you kindly for the view, and an extra special thank you to my wonderful patrons and to those of you who have donated via PayPal. Videos such as this simply wouldn't exist without you. Oh, and check this out. It's not yet healed, and so it's pretty scabtastic, but I thought you'd appreciate it nonetheless. Consider me branded.